Here, we'll introduce the characteristics of Yamecha, which is mainly made in Yame City, Fukuoka Prefecture. And we'll show you how to brew a tasty cup of tea. Yame is in a temperate, rainy region where temperature differences are extreme and the soil is fertile. As Yamecha is cultivated in this climate, its characteristics of strong sweetness and a rich flavor win the favor of tea lovers all over Japan.
大きなヤメ茶のね、特徴の、もう一番大きな特徴というのは、タランチのものに比べて甘みがあると、コクがあるという。だから甘み、旨みが非常に優れているということが一番の特徴じゃないかと言え、思ってます。素材、食材が持っているものに人間がね、いかに美味しく食べるかという、まあそういう、どう付加価値をつけるかということがものづくりのね本来の目的だと思うんですね。いいものを作るやっぱり一番のね大事なことはやっぱり丁寧に作る。いかにいいものを作るかということのね積み重ねで、ですから今日よりも明日ね今年よりも来年いかにいいものを作るかという精神力が一番僕は大きいと思う。
Let's take a look at how to brew tasty tea. Here we will mainly introduce how to brew Sencha. 1. Let boiling water cool. If you pour boiling water into a teapot directly, the temperature will be too high. Pour boiling water into another teacup first. Hold the teacup. When the heat reaches a tolerant level, it means the temperature is about 70 degrees C. Now pour that hot water into another teacup. The temperature will fall another 5 to 10 degrees C. In this way, astringency, which comes out easily with high temperatures, can be controlled. This table shows the criteria of temperatures for brewing the first cup of different kinds of tea. The key to brewing high-quality tea is to do it boldly with cooled-down hot water. Bancha, good-flavored hojicha, and genmaicha should be brewed with boiling water. 2. Put the tea leaves into a teapot. The amount of tea leaves is about 2 to 3 grams per person. Learn to judge the best amount for your own taste preference with a teaspoon. 3. Pour a little hot water. By adding a little hot water, sweetness is condensed and the taste becomes richer. As for the best quantity by tea type, it's proper for a person to drink 25 cc of Gyokuro, 40 cc to 70 cc of Sencha, or 80 cc of Hojicha or Genmaicha. If the taste is too strong, try adding less tea leaves. Wait for 1 minute after pouring hot water. 4. Brew tea in this order. Pour tea in the order of 1, 2, 3, and then in the order of 3, 2, 1. In this way, the amount and the strength of the tea will become uniform. 5. Pour tea completely. The last drop, which is left in the teapot, condenses sweetness. So pour tea completely. And by pouring out the last drop, it can prevent tea leaves from getting soggy. So they can stay tasty for a second time and a third time. 6. When brewing tea for a second time, raise the temperature a bit. Raise the hot water temperature by 10 degrees C over that which was used for the first time. It takes on a sweetness containing a slight astringency and a bitterness in it, and the depth of the taste will come out. After the third time, it's fine to pour boiling water directly onto the tea leaves. You can enjoy a fresh aftertaste.